Hello and welcome to the Pretty Pink Posh YouTube channel. This is Lauren and I'm going to be sharing with you how I created this adorable spring scallop box card. I have the scallop box card dies, the umbrella shaker dies, the nature essential dies, as well as the spring jar stamp set and coordinating dies, and the spring chick stamp set and coordinating dies. I've done all of my die cutting off screen, so you can see here all of the parts that I use from the scallop box card die in different shades of purple cardstock. I also die cut the umbrella out of some purple cardstock and silver, and some green grass from the nature essentials die. I also stamped, colored, and die cut my images from both those stamp sets and have them ready to go for decorating the box card. So let's jump into the card. First, I'm going to be doing a little bit of stenciling with the layered umbrella stencil set, but I'm just going to be using the raindrops, and I'm going to add a little bit of stencil paste to this background piece that will be on the back side of my box card. So I'm just using a mat and magnets to help keep my stencil and paper in place, and then I'm grabbing this blue lunar paste to add in those raindrops, just swiping it across the stencil, and then I will pick up the excess and put it back into the jar, and then I will go rinse my stencil off as quick as I can so it doesn't stay get any stencil paste on it, and then I will go ahead and set that aside to dry. Next, I'm going to stamp my sentiment on this little scalloped rectangle piece. I'm going to grab some Uncharted Mariner in Distress ink to do my stamping inside of my Mini Misty, and I'm going to grab the Sending Smile sentiment from the Spring Chicks stamp set. I'm using my Misty for my sentiment because sometimes I don't always stamp it perfectly in one try. So using the Misty just allows me to get my sentiment centered and straight and be able to stamp it more than once if needed. So like I said, I'm using a Distress ink. This is Uncharted Mariner. I thought the dark blue would just be a nice complement to the purples I have and the green from the grass, and of course the little blue raindrops from my stenciled background. So once I have that all done, it's time to start putting together our box. Now I brought out my scoring tool, but the perforated marks on these die pieces are just perfect, and you actually don't really need a scoring tool. They bend and crease very nicely. I'm going to add some double-sided adhesive tape to all of the flaps on all three of what I call the little shelf pieces, because I'm going to be putting images and die cut pieces on top of them like a little shelf. So I'm going to start with adding all three of these to the left side of my box card here. So I'm just pulling off the release paper just on one side, and I'm going to create what I think will be about thirds on the side of my box card. So I'm going about a third of the way from the back to put on my left piece, and I'm lining it up to the top edge of that slanted side piece, and then I'm going to take my last little shelf and I'm going to put it about a third of the way from the front, and that way it creates some nice even distance between each of the different die cut pieces. Now you can add as many or as little shelf pieces as you want. It just completely depends on what you're wanting to create and how many, critters you want to put on your box card or images. So I decided to go with three so I could put my sentiment on the front, and then I would have two shelf pieces to stack my images. To close up the box, I'm going to actually fold this a little bit more on the difficult way, but I just find that closing the box when the flaps are bent instead or folded over instead of the side piece, it just allows the box to move a little easier and lay flat a little easier. I needed to trim down my grass pieces because I'm going to add these to my two shelves that are on the inside of my box card, and it measures perfectly at 3 1/4. So I'm just going to put these on my paper trimmer and trim the grass down to 3 1/4. I'm going to use some tape runner just to add some adhesive to the back of these grass pieces. And like I said, I'm going to add them to my shelves, the back one closest to the rounded back piece of my box card. And then I'm also going to glue it on the second one, the one that's closest to the front. And this is just to add a little bit of fun grass to my box card because I'm going to be layering on those cute little chick images, and I want them to look like they're playing around in the grass and jumping in puddles. I die cut my two side scallop pieces out of some lilac glitter cardstock, so I'm just gluing those onto the side, and then I will also glue down my sentiment to the front. My background was pretty much dry. I probably should have waited a little bit longer before adding in my stenciled background. I accidentally smear a couple of my raindrops, but luckily they are hidden by the grassy part. All you can really see are just a few. And while I feel like I probably didn't really need to stencil those raindrops on because of how I end up adding my umbrella, they're still there and I think they still add a little bit of fun to the card. So now I'm going to glue together the umbrella. So I'm adding some adhesive to the handle and I'm gluing that onto the shaft of the umbrella. I use the same dark purple cardstock as my box card and I have some kind of silver metallic looking paper to be the shaft and then that same lilac glitter paper to be my umbrella. I just really wanted everything to coordinate on this card. So I glued the umbrella down a little, creating the shaft to be a little shorter than you would probably normally glue the umbrella, but I wanted it to be on my box card and still fit inside of an A2 envelope. So here you're going to see me kind of maneuvering the umbrella around and figuring out how I'm going to add it to the back of this card. I thought that I would just stick it even to the very back of the card, but I really wanted that glitter to show. So I finally kind of figure out that if I angle it a little bit more to the side, you can see the handle of the umbrella and still see all the details of the umbrella. And if I lower it just right, you'll see here, I'm kind of doing the math on my grid mat. I can get it to fit and still be 4 1/4 inches tall, and it will still fit perfectly fine in my A2 envelope. So once I finally figured out that placement, I'm just going to use some wet glue so I have some time for some wiggle room, and I'm going to get that umbrella glued down. So here you can see I did cover up quite a few of those raindrops, but I still think you can see a bunch of them and it still adds a little bit of fun to the card. So now that I'm all done with the card base and adding my umbrella, I'm going to start putting in my images. So I'm going to zoom in here so that way you can see a little better about what I'm doing and how I'm gluing on these images. And then I just put a piece of or a roll of my tape. That way will help keep my box at an angle. I really want to make sure that you can see all the steps I'm doing to glue on these adorable little images. I'm going to start with gluing down my little puddles. I'm going to be using my reversible tweezers quite a bit when gluing my pieces onto the box card, and that's because I can let go of my tweezers and they close, and it allows me to add some pressure to my images being glued down, and that way I know that the glue is really sticking to both pieces of the cardstock. So I have one little chick with his cute little red rain boots on the right, and then I'm going to glue the second puddle on the back, and I'll have another chick on that shelf of images. I also really like to kind of pay attention to how my critters are facing. I don't want my critter who's facing to the left to be all the way to the left side of my card, or a critter facing the right to be all the way to the right. And that's just so it keeps the scene onto the card. It doesn't look like you're missing out on something, like what are those chicks looking at way over there? I know it sounds kind of silly, but that's what I think of when I place my critters on, just trying to keep a nice cohesive scene. I also glued this cute umbrella to my chick who doesn't have any rain protection on, no raincoat, no rain boots, so of course it's going to need a little umbrella. And then I'm going to go through and add these little grass pieces as well as some of the flowers on both of my two shelves. So again, using those tweezers to help me with placing my images down, and then I'm also going to use it to apply pressure to make sure that glue has a little bit of chance to dry or start drying, and I know that my image will stay in place. Again, here I go with a flower, and I'm just going to do a couple of these on camera, but I will add a lot more grass and flower pieces on both of my shelves. I just didn't want to have you sit here and watch the same thing over and over again, so I'll go ahead and skip past some of those additions of adding in those images. To add in the butterfly, I'm going to glue the butterfly trail to the backside of my butterfly so it looks like it's flying from left to right. And then I'm going to use a clear piece of acetate to help me attach my butterfly to the card because I want it to look like it's flying. Now, I could have just used some foam adhesive and attached it to, the umbrella, but I thought having this kind of clear element and having my butterfly pop up out of the card would just be really cute. So I'm using some double-sided adhesive tape, and I'm going to glue this piece of acetate to the back side of my umbrella, of my butterfly. And then I'm going to add some acetate to the bottom, but I'm going to trim it down first and make sure that it won't stick too far out of the bottom of my box card. So I trimmed it so it would have enough coverage to stick to the back side of my back shelf of my box card. I hope that made sense. But I'm sticking it to the back of the dark purple die cut, and I'll show a better close up when I'm all done. And that way you can't see the acetate attaching inside of the box card, and my butterfly looks like it's really flying and floating above my little chicks. I'm adding in some more final touches like my little water droplets from my chicks splashing in the puddles. And then I'm going to add the rest of my flowers and leaves to the front of my box card, surrounding my sentiment and just kind of framing it a little nicer on the front side of my card. I have a little bit more room on the upper right corner, so I'm going to add two flowers as well as the leaves. And I'm just using a jewel picker to help me with picking up those small pieces and kind of maneuvering them around until I like how they look on the card. And then I'll just repeat that process, but this time picking up the flower and adding some glue to the box card and then gluing down my little image. So I'm going to go ahead and do both corners and add these flowers and leaves. And that will finish off my card. Here's a final look at this adorable box card with these cute little images and adding some grass to your little shelves inside of the box card. And I'm going to also show how I attach the butterfly to the back side of this shelf piece. So here you can see that acetate is sticking to the back of my purple cardstock. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and that you'll try adding some more fun to your box card dies as well. I just love how cute this box card turned out, and it's going to be perfect for Easter. Thanks for joining me today. Bye!